We previously did a What's New video about A-axis turning, so make sure to check that out. With A-axis turning, we have a turning insert mounted in the B-axis head of a mill turn machine. We can index it and change the tool vector angle throughout the cut. Using the newly supported Y-axis turning tools, the A-axis turning toolpath extends Mastercam 2025's support for rotary contour turning. If you're still with me, this is the video for you. So let's take a deep dive into the A-axis toolpath and how we can set one up. Now we're going to start by clicking on the A-axis turning toolpath itself. Solid chaining manager appears, and we're going to chain the OD of the part up to the larger OD here. Now we have a similar panel interface to the B-axis turning toolpath. Now I'll probably reference the B-axis turning toolpath a little bit throughout this because they're so similar. We're going to select our tool. Now here we can select our tool number and our feed rate as far as our maximum spindle speed for constant surface cutting. Now the next tab down, we have our plans manager. The nice thing about A-axis turning toolpaths as well as Y-axis turning toolpaths in general is that Mastercam makes the plane for us. So we don't have to worry about anything here. Now next we have our operation tab. Here we can change an approach point or a retract reference position, as well as force a tool change or input any comments that we have. Our next tab is our geometries page. Now here we can select our chain if we want to reselect something, or we can change our comp direction or stock to leave. Followed by lead in and lead out directions. Mastercam does a pretty good job here as well as being able to set this automatically for us. So most of the time we don't have to change that, only when we're fine tuning the toolpath. The next tab is our basic motion control. This is probably the most important page in the A-axis turning toolpath. Now we're gonna set it to automatic, and then we're gonna leave our tool angle limits how they are. And we'll get back into this in a second. Let's go ahead and regenerate the toolpath just to see what we're working with. Now we're going to take a look and backplot the toolpath. And we can see that the tool indexes throughout the cut. Now here I have that same Y-axis turning tool. Now, when it's mounted in the B-axis head, you can imagine it looks something like this. And as we're cutting, the tool will actually index and rotate throughout the cut. So that's what we're seeing here in Mastercam. Now let's go back into the parameters page. Our tool angle limits. Now, just like in B-axis contour toolpath, we have the same tool angle limits, but we're not limited based on the B-axis travel. We can actually go anywhere from positive 180 to minus 180 degrees. The next section down is going to be tool angle control. Now, this is where we're going to set a leading or trailing angle based on our insert itself. So let's go ahead and set a trailing edge angle of 45 degrees. Our fan distance is going to set a tolerance on how much it's going to roll over an edge of a corner. Let's go ahead and backplot the toolpath. Now, as I step through the toolpath, you can get a pretty good idea of what that trailing edge angle is trying to do. Now, I'll shut off the holder, make this a little bit easier to see. Now we're keeping a constant angle on the trailing edge based on our geometry. Now this works pretty well on flat surfaces, but you can see if we step through to a angled surface, it's gonna keep being 45 to the angle of the surface that we're on. Now the toolpath is smart enough to not gouge, so it's gonna make sure that it's not gonna hit the part, but this still might not be ideal, but it's a good example showing exactly what that operation does. Now back in our motion control page, we also have a tool offset angle option and a selection option. We're gonna leave those blank and we're gonna move on to the next page. Next we have advanced motion control. This is where we're gonna set things like cut tolerances, maximum angle steps, as well as maximum insert depth, just like in the B-axis turning toolpath. Last is the stock page. This is where we're gonna be able to adjust our stock to make sure that our lead in and lead out motion doesn't gouge into any remaining material. Mastercam 2025's introduction of both the Y and A axis toolpaths bring our turning capabilities to the next level. By staying at the forefront of innovations like this, we can continue to supply our customers with the capabilities that will set you apart from your competitors.